How was the universe created? What happened before the universe was born? These questions, although might seem silly or trivial, have haunted millions of scientists, and yet we still can't explain all of these questions. However, there is one theory, the Big Bang Theory. At first, the Big Bang Theory wasn't backed up by evidence, which led scientists to oppose it. However, recent discoveries, like the discovery of cosmic radiation, the theory of relativity by Einstein, and much more, had made the Big Bang become the most accepted one. So, how does this Big Bang Theory work? Well, the Big Bang Theory states that at first, the universe started off very, very small, and then, by fractions of nanoseconds, expanded into a huge landmass. And by series of events, lead towards the creation of universe. The first stage of the Big Bang is called the inflation and quark era. Particles called gluons start to form. And these gluon particles soon created more particles, called quarks. This cycle continued on and on until the universe was cold enough that no more quark particles was created. The remaining quark particles soon created more particles called hadrons, like protons and neutrons, the building block for creating atoms. And then the universe started to become more stable and cool down, which is how the protons and neutrons start to create the first atom, hydrogen. Over the next few minutes, everything started to cool down. More hydrogen atoms are created, and the hydrogen atoms are attracted towards one another because of gravity, until there's enough pressure that nuclear fusion took place. This is how stars are born. At this point, the building blocks for creating galaxies, planets, and much more, which are atoms, have already been created. So, by series of processes, those atoms and particles will turn into galaxies, planets, life, and much more. So, that is basically the timeline of the Big Bang, from the creation of quark particles to the formation of star systems. However, there are several details that are left untouched, like what happened before the Big Bang, how was the Big Bang formed, and much more. Well, at this point, our science starts to break down. Natural laws stop making sense, and logic cease to exist. To answer these questions, we need new science. We need groundbreaking discoveries. So, the answer is, we don't know, and we may never will. However, we shouldn't feel sad that we don't know the answers. We ought to feel adventurous, curious, seeking new answers and ideas that can solve these problems. So, let's keep seeking until there are no more questions to ask.